realistically, we can hunt both sides of this creek. No problem.
Yeah.
It would just be if there was one high on that side getting up to him.
Could bushwhack, but yeah. You know what? It doesn't take much to cover country around here. It always surprises me. We start walking and we're there in like, I don't know, a few couple minutes.
Yeah.
The higher we get, the more I like this view. I mean, look at that. Especially because it's so thick. Now we can actually see down into this stuff.
Yep.
If we get up here, I think we're gonna have a good view of if there is a bear in this basin. It won't be able to sneak by us. There's a lot of berries on this slope too. Wouldn't be surprised if we found them right here, you think?
Right on the top here.
We've been up here about 30 minutes, maybe?
Yeah, roughly.
Rain's coming and going. We have a nice bird's eye view, though. This whole valley below us, but we're seeing a lot of animals. Just no bears.
A lot of caribou, some moose.
How many caribou? Probably three different groups?
Three different groups of at least 6 to 7 in each group.
And there's a bull over there that's pretty stout.
Yeah, it was a nice, gonna have a nice set of antlers this fall.
And then down here, there's a nice bull moose down here too. Oh man, dude, it just seems like it's very, like just, we're gonna see a grizz right here. We should. There's no reason not.
It's pretty primo. The mountains are steep, but the valley's pretty flat all the way back. And I almost wonder how flat it gets going around that corner.
It also seems like everything's within shooting range into the valley from here.
From here.
Like, you don't have to go into the valley. If it's on the other side, yeah, for sure. But if something comes down middle of the valley, it's in range.
Yeah. And we could even work up and around right there to get a little closer, too.
Yep. Man, not even a black bear, though.
Nothing. They're all hunkered down with this weather.
Yeah, this
little, still early too for bears.
This little shelter's proven to be pretty handy.
Yeah. Gonna make me spend some more money and get one.
The stove jack is right over here, so, you know, it's pretty killer setup. It'd be toasty in here. You don't have to have a big stove at all.
No, you can run that. Guy. The little U-turn you got would be more than sufficient for it.
Probably roast you out of here, probably. Probably need a little smaller one than that. But just, I like how you can open this and then get a good view. You know,
still be protected.
Still be in this, yeah. Because I need visibility, man.
Yep.
If I'm going to glass out of it. The teepees worked well for that, too. You can open up both doors. Man, you can really feel that Arctic wind, like it'll just be normal, and then all of a sudden out of nowhere it's just some cold ass wind just comes for like just a minute, and then it's warm wind again. It's just a mix of everything.
And we got sleet falling on us right now.
Yeah, a little hail and sleet. Yep. Well, this is bear hunting. We only need one.
Just need one.
Well, the Arctic winds decided they wanted to kick up. So, I don't know. Silex is holding up just fine. It's ripping hard. Climb on in, Chris. It's not too bad. It's actually a lot more spacious in here than you would think. But anyway, it's 2:30. No grizz yet. Seeing so many caribou and moose. but most of the animals are all hunkered down out there. Anyway, we'll let you know if the silex blows away or not.
Holy crap! Woo! Yeah! We might need to pop smoke. I think we better pack up and roll out before we get blown off the mountain.
I saw a moose just walk right through that. See those lakes?
Mm-hmm.
The three river, the little ponds. The next opening beyond that.
Yeah.
I just saw a moose just walk right through all that. Well, this is day three. The first day we flew in and we just camped and it just snowed and dumped rain on us. Yesterday, we got a black bear. A nice black bear. Real pretty, tall. No fat at all on his body, like zero. Just zero. But he had a big old head on him and a really nice coat. Super tall, he had swagger. No doubt, after the summer he puts on all that weight, no doubt he's a pretty stout bear. But he was down, he was just skin and bones. No belly, no fat at all on his hind end. Just, he was lean. So, tough country to make a living in. I love this country, I love this hunt. Super cool, we've seen a lot of fox, a lot of moose. Up that mud flat, where it comes around the back of this mountain, there's a couple of real nice, pretty color phase, like blonde grizzlies back there that some dude saw like a year ago, about this time. So, but they're probably everywhere. I mean, it doesn't take much for a grizz to be from there to here. I mean, they cover ground like crazy. But anyway, we just got the old silex here, and it's been great. I normally bring my Z-Pax tarp. But this pitch is so quick, and as you can see, we can set it up so that you can like glass right out the front of it, and then if you want to, you can raise the back door too, the same as the front, and you can look out the back, and it seals to the ground real tight, and you can toss all your gear in there. Like when we went for our black bear, we just pitched this thing in a minute or two, threw all of our gear under it, and then took off. That way, when we come back, it's all dry. Anyway. Decisions. We'll keep you posted. We have a bit of a game plan today to go 10 miles further into this river drainage. We know there's some bears back there. At least we've been told. So we're kind of thinking it's time to move back in there and see. We've spent a few days here checking it out. We feel pretty good that there's no bears we're leaving behind. We're seeing the same moose, same caribou, same critters out in the meadows in the same spots each day, but still no bears. So if there was a bear over there in those basins roaming around, I'm confident we'd have picked it up by now and seen it. So
across this basin and basically skirt the edge of this mountain right here and drop into the next drainage and go up it. When we were up on top today, we could pretty much glass all the way to the back and up and down this whole basin. Not quite this side, but when we get over there, we'll be able to glass back. But we mostly saw a lot of this drainage and it didn't look like we should spend much time in there. So we're gonna hit the next one, which is ginormous. Well, Chris, this is where the fun begins.
Oh yeah, some bushwhacking.
I think we take this moose trail.
Yeah, just take it right down and we'll go at an angle.
Okay.
Fun times.
Let the games begin.
It ain't hunting if you ain't bushwhacking.
That's right.
And probably way more mosquitoes down here. Got a nice brown bear track. That's a good sized bear. Yeah, it's good. First time we've seen, other than some older scat back on the mountain, so headed in the right direction.
That's the first track we've seen for a long ways. But that's what we're looking for. Heck man, that's a big track. That's a good inland grizz.
Yeah.
Let's go find him. Yeah. Yeah, that's bear. That isn't
bear all day.
Yeah. Moose hair is coarse
moose
and kind of
coarse and hollow and thicker.
Hollow, yeah. That is bear fur hanging off this post. Look, it's all over the bottom, bear fur. We've seen them like get up on there and make these rounds, cruising through every few days, and they hit these posts and rub out. So those tracks are just coming down this trail. They're right in front of here. They're huge. They can't be more than, they're less than a week old.
Yeah, they're not that old. Because all this rain we've had, it would easily dull them out and wash them away, but they're still pretty crisp tracks, so.
There is definitely a big bear somewhere in here. I mean, that post has hair on it.
And that's easy.
It's not a moose. This is a bear rubbing post.
This, I'm 5'7", and this is from the ground up. So it's easily five foot above the ground. He's scratching his back, marking his territory, leaving his scent around here. let the other bears know this is his area. Stay the heck out.
This is the first sign we've seen in quite a while.
A good sign. I mean, this is the whole, as soon as we hit that footprint, the whole way down this trail.
But if a bear was cruising down this trail, you're not going to see him where we were glassing. He's got to come out in these open spots.
It's too thick.
But it's not super fresh, but less than a week old probably.
Big-ass bear, that's all I know. Like, my hand's like 8.5-ish, a little more wide, and that print is every bit as wide as that. I mean, freaking, it's huge.
That's a good bear. Let's go find him.
We've seen a ton of bear sign. We've traveled about 3 miles, 3.5, is it?
3.5, yeah.
And we're heading into this new basin, but of course it is a trail, so you're gonna have a, it's gonna be a bit of a track, trap, you know? Gonna catch a lot of tracks in through here, but they're here. I mean, this is pretty fresh tracks.
Yeah. We've been seeing tracks the whole way down.
And they're going back and forth and
multiple different sizes, so there's a lot of
a lot of different grizz, and they seem to all be grizz tracks. I didn't really see any browns. Or I mean black bears. But we'll see. Anyway, let's do this.
I just glassed up on the top of this face, and I'm pretty sure it's a sow and two cubs way up there. So we'll get the long ones on it and see. But that means there might be a big boy down here. She wants to keep them away.
Pretty color.
Very pretty color. She's really like a gray blonde color.
That was a really good spot because you can see him silhouetted against the snow, but still. But it's the rut, dude. If she's up there, I wouldn't be surprised if there's a boar cruising up there, too. But that is at the top of the mountain. The top. Well, finally. Nice spot, Brad. Because they're on the moon. That's where I expect to see the sow and the cubs. They stay away from these boars, you know. But we've seen our first grizzly right in front of us here. It's way up there. But it is the rut. You would expect to see, you know, a boar pushing around, but although she is, does have cubs, so she's not gonna put up with much. She got two cubs, is that what I'm seeing? Look at them just running around chasing her. Dude, aren't they big? Aren't they big, holy cow. I wondered if we'd see a sow and cub sometime. This happens though, you know, like we see grizz at the top all the time. Big one, males, females. This time of year we see them at the bottom. Like grizz just, they run the gamut, but I do think they like wherever the sow goes with her cubs though. Tends to be where the boars aren't hanging out. Man, they cruise, don't they? They just don't sit still. Cruise.
No.
They just motor. Dude, it's so cool. Love it. Love it. Wish we were closer though. That's gotta be 2 miles.
Oh, easy.
Three? Two and a half? Two or three? Straight line distance. I bet that's 2.5 miles. Right in that ballpark. So cool. We were seeing more grizz sign and finally some grizz than we did way over there. Didn't see any at all. She is a gorgeous color, isn't she?
Yep. Nice blonde on top, chocolate brown on the bottom. Got a good looking bear up there, sow and cubs. They're up there playing, running around chasing mama. Oh, there she goes. Yep, she just dipped over. Some good looking healthy cubs too. She got twins. Always, yeah, they're just motoring up that mountain like it's nothing. Look at them. Unreal. We'll be sucking climbing up that. It's nice and steep. They are way up on top, too. Just keeping them up there, keeping them away from the boar. Don't want those older boars to kill the cubs so the sow comes back into heat. So she's up there keeping them safe. Where she knows she can see everything coming up at him. So hopefully we find the boar, big boar.
Well, we're over here on this beaver pond. There's like a, it's like a 200 foot dam. No, more than that, like 1,000. Cause it wraps up and then comes all the way around. Makes into a giant, giant beaver dam. Huge. It's crazy. Man, what a cool place. Just the scenery. This is just freaking amazing. I love it. That sow and cub, Grizz, we saw up in that pass up there at the very top. Crazy. We just gotta find ourselves a big boar now. We're an old, crusty, dried up sow. But so much bear, crazy tracks everywhere. Pretty cool. So check this out. There's these old tracks where these bears, they step in the same exact spot over and over again. They call it stomp walking. So you got these steps that they take, where they take the same exact step over and over again. All the way right here. And this tree is all one of those rubs with bear hair on it. And it's crazy because it stomp walks right here, boom. It's crazy how they just use the same firm hold and wear it down over time. Because this is some hard ground. This is not soft.
From toe to toe?
Yeah.
That's 5.5 feet.
I want that bear, Chris. Let's find him.
Yeah, it'd be nice.
I know in the lower 48 we find some giants. And you'd think in Alaska, and they're inland, you know, they're not eating fish or anything. They're out there just getting by on elk and deer, just like these moose and caribou. So the occasional beaver and ground squirrel.
Yeah, when they get lucky.
Well, we hiked about 11, 12 miles today. Got back deep into where all these headwaters and glaciers melt off and combine. We got a glacier over here and a glacier over here melting, and the snow-capped mountains melting, and they come down, and we're right where these two things melt and split, and one track goes down here, and the other one goes the other way. Anyway, there's this whole creek bottom is just covered in sign. So, I mean, it's crazy. Like, as we went down this river bottom, it just was everywhere. We're not sure what to do, like where to move to, how to hunt. We're gonna sleep here tonight. We got this Red Cliff all rocked in and windproof, and we found that the river was probably the best place to camp for tonight, just in the sand. So we just pounded those stakes in and rocked it in. So we got a little wood for a fire. We'll cozy up, get some sleep. And then I think we're just gonna glass 360 tomorrow in the morning and throughout the afternoon. And then we'll decide what to do. Hopefully we get eyes on a big grizzly somewhere in here. But if we don't, I'll have to decide whether to stay here for a day or two or push back out.
You know, this isn't the most killable, huntable spot. Like, even if you see a bear, doesn't mean you'll be able to get on it, because there's a mile of willows and thick crap before you get to the base of any hill. And the way these bears move, they don't tend to hold still and just feed in one spot or spend the day in one spot. They motor just up and down and over the tops. We got bear tracks going up through the snow and over this pass. And they're big tracks. Big tracks everywhere. So, I don't know. We're bound to run into a big grizz some point here in the next 5 days, but you have a little anxiety, a little frustration that we're not seeing more bears on their feet. But maybe tomorrow, we will see.
Bald Butte, so lofty and so high, carry me to Bald Butte, where the plains wrap round the sky. You can dig a hole on Bald Butte when I die. Bald Butte, so lofty and so high, carry me to Bald Butte, where the plains wrap round the sky. You can dig a hole on Bald Butte when I die.
All right, folks, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. We have some giveaways to announce. We are giving away a Peaks headlamp, which we announced last week. Mm-hmm. We picked a winner. We're giving away a Stealthy Hunter rifle cover as well, and a pair of sheep feed orthotics from over at Locals. And then we have some new giveaways to announce this week. To be entered to win, remember, all you got to do is like and subscribe to the channel and leave a comment below, especially leave a comment. We select from the comment section.
Yep.
Before we do that, though, I wanted to touch on this film a little bit, give you guys a little backstory. I think it's always interesting when I watch films, I'm very curious,
yeah.
You know, a little more detail on what happened. Some things I learned on this trip was, how do you judge a bear by its track?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I've never hunted where there's this many, like this much grizz sign.
Yeah.
We do come across grizz in some areas that we hunt, and you've seen them on videos if you've watched our series at all, but this was a lot of sign, not just bear tracks, but the stomp walking,
yeah,
and the bear rubs, the bear posts. We didn't show you like three of,
yeah, there were at least three or four posts throughout this whole kind of this big,
yeah,
valley.
When we did our loop on that trail, we only showed you two posts, I think, and there was like five.
Yeah.
Very prominent posts where these bears have been hitting it for years and years and years. And these rub trees, they're serious. We have footage of bears doing this across all the states. Mm-hmm. They get up there and they go to town on some of these old trees. These rub trees have been around a long time. The other thing, if you look at a bear that actually stomp walks in those tracks, you'll see them slam their leg down all stiff-legged, mm-hmm, and kind of twist a little bit. And they're literally in those steps jamming down and marking it for about 10, 12 feet, and then they start, yep, walking normally when they get out of the stomp walk spot.
Yep.
So there's definitely a thing going on there.
It's usually like an entry trail going into the rubbing post and an exit coming out.
Right.
You know,
and they want to hit the steps they always hit and kind of stick it down. It's very fascinating behavior. There's various ways to judge a bear by its track. Mm-hmm. Different people have different opinions. You can judge it based on the rear foot's length.
Yep.
Another common way to do it, like we detailed in the video, is the width. It seemed to me that the width of the front pad was one of the great best indicators.
Most consistent, I think, with as an all-around judgment on bears.
There's some big grizzlies in there. We're not surprised by that. But you'd think you'd run into one. I mean, they're giant, and you see the moose and the caribou and all that everywhere. But it was tough to find a grizz. And if you've watched any grizzly, inland grizz hunts, like Ranella did a few on Meat Eater that I've watched. I'm way into bears, so I've always watched those.
Yep.
I think he's done that hunt twice up in British Columbia, grizz country, and inland grizz on the mountain, and yet hasn't got one yet.
Yeah. Yep.
So it's a tough hunt. It really is. But I think the reward is worth it. We covered a lot of miles on this hunt, like just covered ground. I think that's one of the tricks with bear hunting. Never sit in the same spot for very long. Yeah. Bears do come over mountains into ridges, but black bear, grizzly bear, our experience has been if they're not in the basin, they're not there.
Yeah, and especially in the springtime, because once the snow melts and your grass starts to really green up kind of valley-wide, those bears are cruising. They're starting to get early rut. I mean, they're just on the move.
And when we say, you know, a bear is a 9-foot bear or 8-foot bear, 8.5-foot bear, we're referring to the bears, this bear squared.
Yep.
And we showed you in the video, that's what people usually are referring to is, what is the bear square in feet? And what's interesting is the width of the bear is generally, as far as I know, always greater than the length of the bear. Mm-hmm. And so you might have an 8-foot span and a 7.5-foot long bear nose to tail.
Yep.
So what I found is the width of the bear, the wingspan, is more indicative of when you say a 9-foot bear.
Yeah.
It's usually 9 and some change.
Right.
Because the length of the bear actually subtracts from the overall number when you square it. You know, as you get more into bears and you learn more about them, it's an interesting way to determine them. Now, the skull size is how Boone and Crockett and other forums, they say they judge a bear's overall age and size based on its skull. But I've had very big-headed bears with little bodies that we've taken, and vice versa. Huge bears with little heads.
Yep.
I think squared, the bear hide squared is a much better measurement for judging an overall bear's size.
Right, absolutely.
But I understand the challenges with it, because when you lay a bear hide out, you could stretch an extra 4 inches out of it. Or
That skull, you're only getting that much out of that skull. You can't make it any bigger.
Yeah. Anyway, that's just about judging bears and judging a live bear. We're going to get into that in the next episode, where you actually see a bear. Like, what are the things you're looking for on a grizzly? Like, how do you know if it's a boar or a sow?
Yep.
It's very hard. You kind of can't tell. You know, I mean, literally, I mean, it is tough. And the same is true for black bear as well.
Yep.
There are sometimes you can tell.
Yeah, and like you do get some sure signs, but just from watching a bear.
When you see a big bear, you know.
Yeah.
But there's all those in-betweens where, I mean, it's a substantially large bear. It's mature.
Yeah.
It could easily be a sow. Yeah, taken some giant
perfect
sows.
Examples with Adam Weatherby on his bear. It took me forever to judge that bear because it was bedded, and I'm like, this could be a teeny tiny bear.
Bears are really tough to judge, and without some perspective, but we're going to get into that in the next film, so stay tuned for that. Anyway, we're hoping you're enjoying this series. Let's get into the giveaways. Brad is going to scroll through while I'm talking. He's going to scroll through our YouTube feed. Yep.
So we got 865 comments today, so we got all of them here.
He's just going to kind of mix it up here while we're talking. This is the new Peaks headlamp. This is actually a prototype I've got. I've talked about it before. I love this headlamp. What we were really hoping to get Peaks to create for us was a headlamp that had strong battery power, that lasted a really long time, that was rechargeable, that had powerful LEDs, that gave us a red light, a white light, that had memory, that was lockable.
Yep.
So you don't accidentally turn it on in your pack and then have a dead battery. I want a light that beam shoots far out there, but then also burns a long run time. I've had headlamps in the past that'll give me a bright light, but they'll burn out in an hour.
Yep. And a lot of times you're packing extra AAA batteries.
Or CR2 batteries or some funky weird battery that is expensive and doesn't last long.
Yep.
I think Peaks nailed it with this headlamp. So if you're interested, check out Peaks, peaksequipment.com. And if you use the code GRITTY, you save 10%. So Brad, pick the winner. Who is it?
Says Strider Shadow. Nice black bear. Great shot, too.
Okay, Strider Shadow, email us your address at grittybowman@grittybowman.com, and we will ship this out to you right away.
Mm-hmm.
We have an Instagram winner for sharing our film on Instagram. We have a winner for the Stealthy Hunter rifle cover, and that is...
Cameron Hindmarsh.
Cameron Hindmarsh. He says, always impressed with Brian Called Gritty Films. Time to start planning to do a bear hunt. And the Stealthy Hunter rifle cover looks sleek. Yes, it does. And you are the proud winner. DM us your address, and we will ship out that rifle cover right away.
Yep.
And then over on Locals, if you guys haven't heard about it, we have a Gritty Stealthy Community. It's like a private Facebook group on the Locals platform. To go there, you just type in gritty.locals.com. And if you become a member over there, you're entered to win some prizes. There's exclusive film content over there that people that are only members get to see. And we do live streams. On Monday night, we're going to do another live stream. We try to do them every Monday when we're available. So we'll do one tomorrow night on Monday. Mm-hmm. And we're going to select the winner on that stream for who won the sheep feet orthotics.
Yep. So you have until Monday early afternoon sometime probably.
Yep.
To still enter.
This week, if you leave a comment on the video below, like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, we're going to give away a pair of Peaks Elite trekking poles randomly to some winner. We thank you so much for leaving comments. They really help with the YouTube algorithms, get us out there, and we love reading them as well. We're trying to get through them all, and we respond to questions best we can. I really try to invest time on that platform to get back to people and And I just want to say thanks for the engagement and for leaving those comments. But if you do it this week, you're entered to win a pair of trekking poles. And share our film on Instagram. We're going to do another giveaway there. We're going to give away the Peaks headlamp over there. So go over to Instagram, share the hunt over there. We'll pick another winner. And if you become a member over at Locals, you might win the pair of sheep feet. But also, we're going to do a big Mountain Ops giveaway. We're going to give away 6 tubs of Ignite, different flavors, Citrus Bliss, my favorite pink lemonade.
Mm-hmm.
Some people really like that Bugleberry.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good.
So, get in over there, and you'll be entered to win. And right now, Mountain Ops is doing a giveaway. When you use the code GRITTY, every order gets you entered to win an elk hunt for 2. So you and a buddy, you and your wife, you and your dad, you and your son, go over there, use the code GRITTY, check out the different stuff they've got. In this hunt, I wore the Mountain Ops Merino hoodie. If you're not into the supplements, they've got some great clothing too.
Yeah.
The elk hunt can be archery or rifle, and it's with Bear Mountain Outfitters. So check that out. Use the code GRITTY over there, and you'll save. So that's it for today. Thanks for tuning in, and tune in next week. Find out who those winners are and catch episode 3. Stay gritty.